Now on Coast TV News.
Wednesday, 20s and 30s, scraping frost for sure. More cold weather on the way, and a potent coastal storm could affect us late weekend into next week. I'll have the details coming up.
Payment postponed, the changes in planning that has pushed the project back in Rehoboth Beach from its original scheduled start date.
Cannabis cold shoulder the restrictions to recreational marijuana made this week in Fenwick Island.
Police department debut, the unveiling of the new station in Milford, and what led to the need for this facility.
This is Coast TV News Today.
It is Wednesday, December 13th, 2023. Good morning. I'm Matt Pensick.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Paige Marley. Thank you for being up with us during our 5 o'clock hour.
Yeah, Paige, I've got shopping plan for this weekend. Countdown is on. We are 12 days away from Christmas.
I'm going shopping, too, this weekend because I realized 12 days away from Christmas.
Right.
If, you know, we've got to order those packages soon, and now I'm worried they're not going to come in time.
Oh, I know, because I look at these things on the website. Like, you need to order, and it was today.
Ooh, or, like, you need to have ordered yesterday.
If you want it before Christmas.
Exactly. Like, Well, sorry if we're getting you a little nervous for the holiday, if you haven't ordered your gifts yet. Come shopping with Matt and I this weekend.
We'll have fun.
We'll have a lot of fun. Let's bring in First Alert meteorologist Bob Trihe. Bob, have you finished your Christmas shopping?
I would have to start it first before I finish it. So, no, I have not yet, but I'm getting there. Hard to believe we're less than 2 weeks from Christmas. Holy cow. Temperatures out the door feeling like Christmas this morning. 20s and 30s, pretty frosty. 29 Delmar and Redden, 34 in Millsboro. Milton, 31. A little warmer along the coast. Maybe you're frost-free there, 40 Indian River Inlet. Thankfully, the winds are light, a little stronger along the coast, so that feels like temperature just a little cooler than the actual temperature as we're looking at mainly clear skies right now. We continue in a cold flow. We've got a reinforcing cold front that's going to just continue to push in that colder air. Here's future cast this morning, lower 30s, upper 30s, lower 40s mid-morning. And then by noon, we're into the mid to upper 40s. So we'll be chilly with a northwest wind. And by 1:30, I think we're into the upper 40s, but then falling very quickly as we go through the evening as those winds start to pick up from the northwest later on. We do gradually start to warm things up. We're talking about the potential for a big storm early next week, a coastal storm bringing rain and wind. I'll talk about that coming up.
All right, Bob, thank you so much. This morning, police are continuing their investigation into a tractor trailer crash in Frankfort. This happened last night. According to the Frankfort Volunteer Fire Company, this crash happened just after 7 p.m. and a hazmat crew was called to the scene. Delaware State Police told Coast TV News that crash was serious. It closed the southbound lane of Route 113 between Daisy Road and Parker Road.
Developing news out of Rehoboth Beach as the repaving of the main strip getting pushed back yet again. The city says it is trying its best to get the Rehoboth Avenue project done. This was initially set for completion in the off-season of this year, but then it was pushed back to early 2024. Well, now the city is saying the project won't begin until after Labor Day of next year. This is a joint effort between the city and DelDOT, and according to the city, there have been late design changes that have caused delays on the project. But Rehoboth Beach is looking forward to seeing the project complete.
It's always tough coordinating between agencies, especially tough on Rehoboth Avenue because DelDOT maintains from the bridge down to 2nd Street, and then the city is responsible for 2nd Street to the boardwalk. So we wanted to make sure that we're doing it all at the same time. It really didn't make sense to just do part of it.
And we did reach out to DelDOT for an interview. The department chose not to comment at this time.
Yet another town is joining the long list of towns on the coast saying no to marijuana. Fenwick Island voted to ban marijuana businesses within town limits on December 8th at its second marijuana reading meeting. This ban covers every type of marijuana business you can think of, from dispensaries to marijuana smoking lounges. Under the Marijuana Control Act, which made smoking recreational pot legal in Delaware, towns do have the authority to ban the sale or cultivation of marijuana within their town limits.
Well, it could run out of money next month. It's the word from the Delaware State Housing Authority's Mortgage Relief Program. Homeowners in need, they are encouraged to apply for assistance as quickly as possible as funding is limited. And according to the authority, over $34 million in financial assistance has been dispersed to more than 2,800 Delaware families across the state.
After several years of planning and drawing support from the community, the new Milford Police Department building is finally open. The city began plans for that facility when they realized that they had outgrown the one built for only 18 officers. Now the city has 37 officers and a population over 12,000. Despite being a police station, Chief Cecilia, she says that the public will also have access to use those amenities in the brand new facility.
It's been a long road, but one that we are happy to have walked that journey, and we just couldn't be more thankful to the community for giving us this gift and this opportunity, and we hope to return it.
There will be more tours at the new Milford Police Department today from 1 to 5 and one Thursday from 4 until 8.
Got an update on a story that we've been covering, changing the daily and hourly parking fees in Dewey Beach. This will be reviewed at the town council meeting later this week. Current daily rate is $25. That would go up to $30. Hourly parking would go from $3 to $3.50. Officials say this is part of an effort to increase available money for town projects.
Sussex County says its top engineer is retiring. Hans M. Medlars was appointed county engineer back in 2015. He says after some six decades of service, now is the time to ease into retirement. In Sussex County, Medlars helped introduce a reimbursement process for private development using public infrastructure, part of expanding the South Coastal Region wastewater facility, and for rewriting county codes for land use and utilities. The county says Medlars will retire in early 2024, but he will stay close out of a variety of projects and assist his yet-to-be-named successor during the upcoming transition.
Yeah, speaking of that, Page, the county says council voted on Tuesday to offer Medlars' vacant position to an interviewed candidate. According to the county, the engineer's role oversees the staff of nearly 180 people who design, construct, and maintain county projects. Projects like public wastewater systems and county facilities. And if the person interviewed accepts, the county hopes to have them on board next month. Well, moving on, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky made his case for money funding his war-torn country. Zelensky met with President Biden and lawmakers on Capitol Hill on Tuesday.
Yeah, his visit comes as lawmakers debate more funding for Ukraine, Israel, and the U.S. southern border. NBC's Bree Jackson shows us more.
President Zelensky delivering an in-person message to leaders in Washington, emphasizing the urgent need for continuing aid to Ukraine.
We are fighting for our country and freedom, and also in Europe, we say for our freedom and yours.
The Ukrainian president met with lawmakers as part of a last-ditch effort to secure nearly $60 billion in funding.
President Zelensky made it so clear how he needs help, but if he gets the help, he can win this war.
There is bipartisan support for sending more money to both Ukraine and Israel, but Congress is struggling to reach a deal. House Speaker Mike Johnson says Republicans also want other priorities met.
We needed clarity on what we're doing in Ukraine and how we'll have proper oversight of the spending of precious taxpayer dollars of the American citizens, and we needed a transformative change at the border. Thus far, we've gotten neither.
GOP lawmakers say at this point in negotiations, it's unlikely an agreement will be reached by the end of this year.
I think it's going to take the president himself telling his cabinet and telling his staff, get this done.
After hosting Zelensky at the White House, President Biden stressing Congress must act.
The world's watching what we do. Would you send a horrible message to an aggressor and allies if we walked away at this time?
President Biden also announcing $200 million in pre-approved aid for Ukraine. In Washington, Bree Jackson, NBC News.
And Zelensky has visited Washington several times since the war began. The Biden administration announced a nearly $325 million aid package for Ukraine after Zelensky's visit in September.
All right, well, we are just getting started this morning, Matt.
Yeah, coming up, Paige, Code Purple, in urgent need of volunteers this season. We'll tell you how they've already had to lessen operations in Sussex County.
And it's crunch time. We'll tell you how long you have to send that Christmas mail so it arrives on time for the holiday.
And the Woodland Ferry closed again. We'll tell you when you can expect it to reopen. All that and more as Coast TV News Today continues.
The new upscale OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro is the place to go for fresh, hand-selected ingredients used to create the most delicious Asian delicacies. Come dine in, have a drink, and let our skilled chefs prepare your authentic Thai, Chinese, and Japanese dishes. At OC Chopsticks, we take what was good and make it better. Sushi rolls, noodle soups, General Tso's chicken, you see where we're going. Anything made fresh is better. Serving lunch and dinner daily, located at the Ocean City Outlets. OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro. We stay fresh.
Coast Country and Spicer Brothers have teamed up to help out our friends and neighbors in need and to support the causes that better the lives of all who live on Delmarva. If you know of a family in need or a charitable cause that could use some help, go to CoastCountry.com and fill out the form today. Each month, we'll select a special event to feature and attend with a live remote broadcast. Coast Country Cares, built by Spicer Brothers Construction. Learn more at CoastCountry.com.
It takes spunk and grit to spin the wheel.
I'm very, very competitive. I'm good at everything, baby.
She called me baby.
Next wheel.
Wednesday at 7 on Coast TV.
Next Jeopardy.
The semifinals of this Champions Wild Card competition. Look up in the sky. It's
high-flying returning champs. Which one will make it to the finals?
Good luck, champs.
Wednesday at 7:30 on Coast TV.
Doctors, lawyers, teachers, bus drivers, cashiers, librarians, the helpful smile of a helper, a caretaker, a healer, a giver can also hide the deepest suffering. Domestic violence impacts everyone, even our everyday heroes. What is your voices here to help? Call our helpline at 302-467-3310 or visit whatisyourvoice.org.
We're seeing starry skies on this Wednesday morning. Tyndall's Casual Furniture Cam. Also some high clouds. 31 in Laurel right now, so we're scraping frost. A lot of inland areas, 20s and lower 30s. A little milder along the coast, so I think you're frost-free there. We're seeing light winds at the present time, and we're seeing mainly clear skies, so it will be a nice day, just awfully chilly. Here's a bus stop forecast for the kiddos. Make sure they bundle up off to school. Temperatures near freezing, 32, and then heading home still. Need that heavier coat, staying chilly. Chilly, mostly sunny, and 48.
Well, happening today, the Lewis Board of Public Works conducting a hydrant flow test, according to the department. Test will take place on Bay Avenue and Pintail Court. During the work, officials say there may be lower water pressure or discolored water for up to 24 hours, and it can be visible throughout the system, not just that area being tested. If this does happen, run the water on cold for 10 to 15 minutes until it clears, and do not do any laundry during the flow test. The Woodland Ferry will be closed today until noon. This will be for inspection. DelDOT says the ferry will resume to normal operations in the afternoon. Also, DelDOT says there will be lane closures next week in Georgetown. This will be on northbound Route 113 in the area of Aero Safety Road. The closures start on December 20th between 9 to 3 p.m. for pavement repairs.
Delivery deadlines to ensure everyone gets their gifts in time for Christmas. The United States Postal Service is recommending that the holiday mail be sent out by December 16th, a few days from now, for it to arrive by Christmas. Meanwhile, FedEx is recommending a shipping date no later than December 15th, that's this Friday, and UPS recommends packages be shipped out by December 19th, but by using 3-day select. Netflix is out with its most transparent data to date about its viewership. The report covers a 6-month period from January to June of this year. Netflix viewers spent the most time watching the following: The Night Agent, I watched that, season 1, with more than 812 million hours. Coming in second place, Jenny and Georgia, season 2, and The Glory, season 1, had more than 660 million hours each. Still to come this morning, Code Purple in urgent need for volunteers to keep the doors open overnight. We'll tell you why the organization says volunteering is so important to those in need.
We're seeing frosty conditions inland this morning. Otherwise, a little milder along the coast, lower 40s in Ocean City right now. More cold weather on the way with a potent coastal storm possible into early next week. I'll detail it on FutureCast coming up.
We all love the warmth and comfort of carpet in our homes, but worrying about spills and pets is a constant. What if I told you the latest in carpet innovation is spill-proof and pet-proof? It'll save the day. It's like magic. The liquid is just beading up. No soaking in, no stains. Get the ultimate carpet protection with Floor Coverings International. We will bring our mobile showroom right to your door.
For more information, visit DelmarvaExperts.com.
Come out for the Delmarva Shorebirds Hot Stove Banquet, Thursday, February 8th at the Wicomico Youth and Civic Center. Get your tickets today, which include a buffet-style dinner and your opportunity to meet former Orioles pitcher Ben McDonald. Plus, there'll be a cash bar and silent auction with sports memorabilia from your favorite MLB and minor league teams. Proceeds benefit the Shorebirds Fly Together Fund. Tickets available now at theshorebirds.com.
Local businesses are the lifeblood of our communities. When you're shopping for gifts this holiday season, please buy local.
I'm Paige.
And I'm Leah from Coast Life, and we're urging you to buy from businesses on Delmarva this holiday season.
Whether it be cars, toys, or furniture.
When you shop local, you support your local community, you protect local jobs, and you strengthen the local economy.
So let's use our buying power.
Because together, we make Delmarva stronger.
Welcome to the ride home on Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3. First rule of the ride home, we definitely talk about the ride home. In fact, tell all your friends. Second rule of the ride home, we have fun. Top 10 Tuesday, Would You Rather Wednesday, and every day, you pick the songs on the high five. And the third rule of the ride home, we don't take ourselves too seriously. You've got enough to stress about. So let me handle the ride home weekdays from 3 to 7 on Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3.
All right, it is 5:16 a.m. on this Wednesday morning, and in the middle of your screen, we got a live look there at Ocean City. If you're heading to your car soon, Bob, I think people should factor in a little extra time because of that frost that has built up overnight.
I would think so, Matt. Those garages certainly come in handy on a morning like today, and so do those fobs with the remote starter on them. So we'll take a couple of extra minutes to scrape off the frost for sure, about 1 to 2 extra minutes, so make sure you do that. Also, make sure to scan the QR code down there in the lower left part of your screen. That will get you to the Coast TV weather app. Temperature-wise, we're looking at 20s and lower 30s out there this morning. We are scraping the frost. 29 in Delmar, 30 in Seaford, 31 in Milton, 40 Indian River Inlet at Bethany Beach at 37. So a little milder along the coast as we have light winds, but it just takes a little bit of a breeze to knock that feels like temperature down. Mostly clear skies right now. We're looking at mainly clear skies as we go through the day. We continue in a west-northwest flow, but there's another cold front to our north and west, and that will reinforce the colder air as we go into this afternoon, tonight, and especially tomorrow as some icy air is building in behind that front. Here's futurecast this morning in the 30s, lower 40s by mid-morning. I think we're looking at mostly sunny skies, mid to upper 40s by noon. By 2:30, we're looking at below average temperatures into the mid 40s and then 30s and 40s this evening. And then through the overnight, very, very cold. We're looking at temperatures by morning, I think, in the 20s and 30s. And then for Tuesday, only in the low 40s for highs into the afternoon for Thursday. Here's our future feels like temperatures. We're looking at upper 30s this afternoon and then through the overnight, very, very cold with the wind feeling like low to mid 20s by morning. And then by Thursday afternoon, only feeling like 30s. And then for tomorrow night into Friday morning, feeling like 20s once again. Want to fast forward into Sunday and Monday. We're watching a coastal storm, and it will bring us impacts, we believe. We still don't know the strength of this system, but it looks like rain, wind, and certainly coastal impacts, maybe beach erosion, maybe 1 to 3 inches of rain as we go into Monday, and very strong winds. But note all the green. There's not a lot of cold air around, so it looks like just a rainy, windy system, and we'll be watching that very closely. Here's our Paul Davis 7-day forecast. 48 today, down to 27 Thursday morning, 42 the high on Thursday, but then we start to warm it up. 52 Friday, mid-50s for the weekend, dry Saturday. That rain builds in on Sunday, and it gets heavy, and it gets windy on into Monday. Our umbrella winner today is Howard Travers Jr. from Salisbury. Congratulations, Howard, on your brand new umbrella from Paul Davis and Coast TV.
All right, thank you, Bob, and as we deal with another cold morning, Code Purple shelters in Sussex County are in need of immediate help in order to continue operating. The Love in Christ organization, also known as Love Inc., operates all Code Purple shelters in the county and says There's been a shortage of overnight volunteers this season. Loving says a few of the shelters in Sussex County have had to temporarily close at night due to a lack of overnight volunteers. And while all volunteers are necessary, the overnight ones, they are the ones that enable the shelters to stay open during the biggest time of need.
They're extremely grateful for the sense of, like, they matter and that their lives matter. You know, someone gave up a night, you know, even if they work, so that I could have a warm place to sleep at night.
In addition to providing people with that warm place to sleep, shelters provide snacks, personal hygiene products, sometimes even meals. The organization says volunteering a night of your time can help save someone's life.
So here are the Sussex County locations for Code Purple. In Seaford, women can stay at Grace Seaford Church. Men can stay at St. Luke's Parish Hall. In Georgetown, men can stay at Georgetown Presbyterian. In Milford, women and their children can stay at Milford Nazarene. Men can stay at Avenue United Methodist Church. And in Lewis, men can stay at St. Jude's the Apostle.
Yeah, and this brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know, how can the community best support emergency shelters?
Let's take a look and see what you think. These are updated results from overnight. 51% of you say supply the essentials. 22% of you donate funds. 27% offer your time. That's what Love Inc. is asking for. Zero. I don't know the last time we had a zero. Say spread the word. Okay, well, if you haven't voted yet, you still can. Head to CoastTVNews.com or our mobile app. We will be right back.
Weather shapes our lives. At Coast TV, our First Alert weather team is always at work, ensuring you have the information you need.
So we're looking forward to begin to make its way towards Fenwick Island pretty quickly here.
Because we know how much weather matters to our coastal community.
Make sure you take cover from these storms.
Our promise is to guide, inform, and protect.
Make sure you are remaining weather aware tomorrow.
Weather coverage that prioritizes you. Coast TV and the First Alert weather team. Your safety, our commitment. Watch for the IG Burton First Alert Weather Jeep.
NBC Nightly News, weeknights at 6:30 on Coast TV.
Have you just inherited a home or property and are feeling overwhelmed? First of all, secure what's now become yours against weather, theft, and trespassers. Keep it maintained, or you could face costly repairs and fines. Keep up with the mortgage and taxes, or face foreclosure. And before you sell, if that's an option, be sure to contact a professional home buyer. Delmarva Dave is here to help. For more information about Delmarva Dave, visit DelmarvaExperts.com.
Be a penguin on New Year's Day at the AGH Penguin Swim. Come out to Ocean City on New Year's Day or join our Cyber Swim and take an ice cold dip wherever you are. Proceeds benefit the Atlantic General Hospital Foundation. For more info and to register in advance, visit AGHPenguinSwim.org.
Glassman, what are you doing?
I decided I wanted to be Santa Glass this year.
You can't do the voice. Stop it.
Come on.
At least, can we give away all the cool stuff?
It slays the holidays, and this year we're giving a prize a day for the entire month of December.
That includes concert tickets, autographed guitars, drum heads, and more.
From these artists and more.
Slays the Holidays is brought to you by Wilkins Wildlights.
More details at 93.5thebeach.com.
Coming up this week on the Delmarva Home Show. We're touring your holiday houses. We asked Delmarva Home Show viewers to send us pictures of their interior holiday decor, and boy, did you all deliver. We're showing off those holiday homes to you. One home in Laurel has a primitive farmhouse style with many decorations. Another has unique decor that the homeowners have been collecting for years, and the final home is a winter wonderland. You can watch the Delmarva Home Show on Sundays at 11:30 a.m. on WBOC.
Take your favorite radio station with you wherever you go. Download free today.
Some troubling news about education in Delaware. New report by the American Institutes for Research shows the state students lag behind those of other mid-Atlantic states, and they've declined over the past decade. This is even before the COVID-19 pandemic. Some recommendations to improve this situation include spending an even larger amount of taxpayer money on public schools, distributing more resources according to student need, improving transparency when it comes to taxpayer money while allowing more flexibility in how districts use those funds, and regularly reassessing property values. The report is available on our website, CoastTVNews.com.
Southern Delaware Tourism is launching its 8th annual Southern Delaware Tourism Photo Contest, encouraging both locals and visitors to participate. Entries will be accepted from January 1st through March 8th, with winners being announced March 22nd. This contest includes four categories that are grand prize, holidays and events, amusements and boardwalk bites, yum, and action shots. Prizes for the grand prize and individual category winners include hotel stays, gift certificates, and more.
Well, so you bring back First Alert meteorologist Bob Trihe. Okay, it's cold, we know that, but then again, it's mid-December, so I guess what should we expect? No complaints on the cold.
No complaints yet until I say we're probably not going to have a white Christmas. I know. Oh, here come the complaints. I know. Sorry. It's looking like a brown Christmas. Anyway, at the beaches today, we are looking at pretty chilly conditions. Fenwick Island and Ocean City beginning in the 30s, close to 50 by the noon hour. And then, of course, 5 o'clock now, the sun is down. Temperatures into the 40s. We're looking at waves around 2 to 3 feet. Lewis and Rehoboth, temperatures into the upper 40s to around 50. So bundle up on that ferry ride to Cape May. Temperatures do warm into the weekend. Then we're talking about a rainstorm and wind. It's early next week. More on that coming up in a couple of minutes.
Coming up after the break on Coast TV News today, Ukrainian president in the U.S. asking for more help to help its war with Russia. We'll tell you why Republicans are holding off on approving this deal just yet.
Also, another Sussex County community voting to ban marijuana within its limits. We'll tell you the details for the restrictions of the drug under this particular ban.
And a repaving standstill. We'll tell you about that project in Rehoboth Beach and why it has been delayed again. Coast TV News Today, we'll be right back.
Shop with Steve Mons. Weekday mornings, 6 till 10. Big 107.7.
Over 100 boys and girls basketball teams. 5 days of the best high school basketball talent in the country. 8 games a day. And it's all on the Delmarva Sports Network. The 41st Annual Governor's Challenge High School Basketball Tournament lives right here on the Delmarva Sports Network. From the first tip of the day to the wrap-up show each night, DSN is there. Download the Delmarva Sports Network app to see the action from every court. The 41st Governor's Challenge, exclusively on DSN. Presented by OC Floor and Home Gallery.
Come out for the Delmarva Shorebirds Hot Stove Banquet, Thursday, February 8th at the Wicomico Youth and Civic Center. Get your tickets today, which include a buffet-style dinner and your opportunity to meet former Orioles pitcher Ben McDonald. Plus, there'll be a cash bar and silent auction with sports memorabilia from your favorite MLB and minor league teams. Proceeds benefit the Shorebirds Fly Together Fund. Tickets available now at theshorebirds.com.
It's my week of wishes, which means giveaways. Make sure you watch TamFam because you can win too. Woo!
I gotta catch my breath.
And on the next Tamron Hall, it's our third annual holiday potluck, and we've got some of the biggest names in food. Top Chef winner turned host Kristen Kish is here, and they've got the Beats and the Bites, the Podash Twins. Plus, just wait until you see the giveaways we're cooking up next Tamron Hall.
Wednesday at 3 on Coast TV.
This is Coast TV News Today.
December 13th, 2023. Good morning, everybody. I'm Matt Pensick. Good morning, Paige.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Paige Marley.
5:28 a.m. on this Wednesday morning. Yep. Paige, being outside, I feel like we've got that Christmas feel.
Yeah.
Just don't have the Christmas look. No snow.
No snow, yeah. But there's some good news for you specifically.
Oh, specifically
yeah.
Me.
Yeah, it's a great day. Did you know it's Taylor Swift's birthday?
Paige, you made my day. Thank you for doing that.
You're welcome.
All right.
I am just warning everybody. It's going to be all over social media.
I'm glad. I think that's more of a warning than a good news.
Right.
Heads up, folks.
Depending on who you are. Let's bring in First Alert meteorologist Bob Trihe. Because like Matt just said, Bob, no snow for Taylor Swift on her birthday.
No. Well, it depends where she is. I mean, she is a world traveler, so it really all depends. We are looking at a chilly start here in Delmarva, 29 Delmar, 29 Seaford, 31 in Milton, a little milder, so to speak, along the coast. So maybe no frost for you, but scraping the frost inland. We have light winds, and we're looking at mainly clear skies right now, but we're in this cold northwest flow, and we've got another cold front that is pressing down from the north and west, and that will move in today, and that will reinforce that cold air and kick up the winds as well. So mid-morning, we're in the low 40s. We'll see some clouds from time to time. Here's noon, 46, we'll say upper 40s by mid-afternoon, and then we'll see that next push of really cold air. So here's the checklist for today. Need the hat and gloves, a heavy coat, the warm beverage, the ice scraper this morning, and make sure you have the sunglasses as well.
Will do, Bob. Thank you. Well, those cracks and those potholes you drive over on Rehoboth Avenue, they're going to be there a little bit longer. There's now a new timeline for the long-planned Rehoboth Avenue repaving.
Paige, this is not the first time this project's been delayed, and the city says the avenue is in much need of some love. Yeah. Coast TV News reporter Charles Reinert shows us when you might actually be able to expect some changes down there on the main strip.
Lots of cars, lots of people, and lots of wear and tear on Rehoboth Avenue. The city was supposed to start a major repaving project this year, but now that has been pushed back until after next Labor Day. Rehoboth Beach Public Works Director Kevin Williams says there are a lot of patches and spots that need some TLC.
I mean, if you drive up and down, you can see the wear. I mean, it was built in, what, 2005? So it's coming up on 20 years, and that's a pretty good lifespan for an asphalt road that gets this much traffic.
This is not the first time the project has been delayed. It was supposed to start after Labor Day of this year. Then it was pushed to early 2024, and now it's been delayed more than a year. This is a joint effort with DLDOT to get the job done, but Williams says late design changes on the state's end has slowed progress.
We did reach out to DLDOT today for an interview on the topic, and it declined.
Williams says there are plans to work on the avenue at night to try and avoid crowds during the day. Cameron Maktovich says the road could be improved.
There could be some other alternative material choices to look at if the concern is safety, kind of keeping traffic at a slower, safer, more manageable level, something with some texture.
A long-discussed project hitting a red light.
According to Williams, there's also some construction work that would coincide with the repaving of Rehoboth Avenue, but that construction would be outside of Rehoboth out on Route 1. I'm Charles Reinert in Rehoboth Beach, Coast TV News.
Well, this morning, Delaware State Police continue their investigation into a tractor-trailer crash in Frankfort. This happened last night. According to the Frankfort Volunteer Fire Company, the crash was after 7 p.m. and a hazmat crew was called to the scene. State Police tell Coast TV News that the crash was serious and closed the southbound lane of Route 113 between Daisy Road and Parker Road.
The Delaware State Housing Authority's Mortgage Relief Program is expected to exhaust its funds by early 2024, if not sooner. Homeowners are now encouraged to apply for assistance as quickly as possible, as funding is now limited. According to the Housing Authority, over $34 million in financial assistance has been disbursed to more than 2,800 Delaware families across the state.
Got another community on Delmarva banning marijuana to tell you about. Fenwick Island voted to ban marijuana businesses within town limits on its second marijuana reading meeting. This ban covers every type of marijuana business you can think of. We're talking dispensaries to marijuana smoking lounges. Under the Marijuana Control Act, which made smoking recreational pot legal in Delaware, towns do have the authority to ban the sale or cultivation of marijuana within town limits.
On December 15th, Dewey Beach commissioners will be looking to discuss the possible ordinance to amend the current daily and hourly parking fees. The current daily rate is $25. That would go up to $30. Hourly parking would go from $3 to $3.50. This is part of the town looking to make more revenue for its town projects. Well, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky met with President Joe Biden at the White House Tuesday. Zelensky's in Washington to lobby for more aid in the war with Russia. In their Oval Office meeting, President Biden announced $200 million in additional aid from the Defense Department. But he stressed that Congress will need to act to get Ukraine the support they need to defeat Russia. Republicans have pushed back against Biden's proposed aid package, holding out for Democrats to pair the aid with tougher border policies.
Well, the United Nations General Assembly overwhelmingly voted in favor of demanding a ceasefire, an immediate ceasefire in Gaza. This is a rebuke to the United States.
Yeah, definitely. Last week, it blocked a similar resolution in the smaller Security Council. And this all comes as the FBI and DHS issued a joint statement saying the ongoing war in Gaza could inspire lone actor violence on U.S. soil during the holiday season. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin will both be in Israel this week for key meetings. And the Biden White House is warning Israel that its campaign against Hamas is losing international support. Well, the White House Rules Committee passed a resolution to launch a formal impeachment investigation into President Biden. This resolution will now head to the House floor for a vote. The 9-4 vote along party lines happened after hours of debate and 9 failed Democratic amendments. If it passes, which would require the support of nearly all of the 221 Republican representatives, a formal inquiry would begin.
Got a lot more news to get to in this edition of Coast TV News Today. Don't go anywhere.
Still ahead, Lewis being named one of HGTV's 50 favorite small towns to visit. We'll tell you what was highlighted that earned Lewis a spot on that list.
Also, the Cape Henlopen boys basketball team facing off against Smyrna. We got details of that game last night.
And beloved actor Andre Brower has died at the age of 61. We'll tell you about his decades-long career that earned him more than one Emmy Award. Stay with us on Coast TV News Today.
We salute Burl Petty John Jr., a World War II veteran. Burl dedicated his service as a maintenance engineer stationed in Burma, India in the early 1940s. His contributions were vital in supporting military operations during a pivotal time in history.
Spicer Brothers and Coast TV are honoring military persons and first responders serving Delmarva. If you have a family member, friend, or community member that you would like to nominate for a Coast TV salute, go to CoastTVSalutes.com.
Elevate your business and engage more customers with Draper Media. Our diverse network of media properties such as WBOC, Coast TV, 93.5 The Beach, and 102.5 WBOC reaches over 500,000 Delmarva residents across various channels like television, radio, social media, and digital platforms. Enhance your brand's visibility across the Delmarva region with Draper Media. Our passionate team of media specialists and content creators are dedicated to showcasing your brand through engaging commercials, dynamic drone footage, eye-catching graphic and web design, and social media branding. Share your brand story on our popular programs, capturing the attention of your target audience. Trust your brand with Draper Media, a family-oriented company serving the Delmarva community. Contact Frank Hamilton today at fhamilton@wboc.com to get started.
At Homewell, our caregivers are compassionate, our care managers are responsive, and our process is built on honest and open communication. This process is what gives us the ability to fulfill our purpose and ensures your peace of mind remains our top priority. Homewell Care Services. Trusted care. True compassion.
Take a stroll down our magical Christmas lane every weekend at Hudson Fields. Merry Christmas from Shell Brothers.
5:38 on this chilly Wednesday morning. Probably frost-free in Ocean City right now at 41. Dry attack cam still seeing the stars out there. Frosty inland, 29 Redden, 29 in Delmar. Salisbury also below freezing, so we're scraping frost inland areas. While along the coast, middle 30s to right around 40 for Indian River Inlet. We're seeing a westerly breeze, a little stronger along the coast, so that's knocking that feels like temperature down. As we're looking at mostly clear skies, another chilly day, and reinforcing cold air with a cold front off to our northwest. That builds in as we go into tonight. Green light for the morning commute. We're looking at a frosty start and still chilly this afternoon, but looking good for your afternoon commute. Well, next year we could see some changes to Delaware's alcohol sales laws.
Yeah, lawmakers are considering allowing online wine shopping and home delivery of alcoholic beverages.
Yeah, Delaware is currently one of just a few states where direct shipment of wine to consumers is banned. State Representative Mike Smith leading an effort to enable direct-to-consumer wine sales under specific conditions.
Another proposed bill would allow various alcoholic beverages to be sold directly by farm breweries, microbreweries, and craft distilleries. These bills will undergo hearings in the upcoming legislative session.
Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
Good morning, sports fans. Smyrna boys basketball looking for revenge over Cape Henlopen after the Vikings topped the Eagles last season. This Henlopen North clash takes us to Lewis, Delaware, where Cape Henlopen knocks off Smyrna 61-44. The home squad, the Vikings, advance to 2-0 on the season, and Smyrna falls to 0-1. Jack Shell led Cape with 17 points in the contest. Next up, Cape takes on Sussex Central, and Smyrna takes on Polytech on Thursday. And the Capitals and the Wizards could be moving from Washington, D.C. to Virginia in the near future. Monumental Sports and Entertainment is expected to announce a plan to move the squads to the Potomac Yard area. The project will build a new sports district and new stadium, a 3,000-seat music venue, and more. Assuming the proposal gets approved, construction would begin in 2025, and the teams would move in 2028. To Division III college field hockey, Salisbury University fifth-year Mac Dinopoulos and freshman Marley McDormand were selected to the All-American second team by the National Field Hockey Coaches Association. Dinopoulos scored 4 goals and had 8 assists on the season, and McDormand led SU with 26 points and 10 goals this year. That'll do it for sports. Have a great day.
The next role for the star of Stranger Things is another strange situation. David Daniel has that and some more in today's Hollywood Minute.
Run from me, darling. You better run.
Millie Bobby Brown tries to escape her fate as a sacrifice to a dragon in Damsel. Netflix has announced the fantasy action adventure will debut March 8th.
We have to get the facts right. We have to be guided by the history, but we're trying to give the audience an experience.
Which the Saturn Awards is giving Oppenheimer director Christopher Nolan its Visionary Award. The Academy of Science Fiction, Fantasy, and Horror Films describes the honor as a testament to Nolan's exceptional contributions to the world of cinema. Emily Blunt, who's nominated for a Saturn Award for Oppenheimer, will present Nolan with the honor. The 51st annual Saturn Awards are February 4th.
I'd like to play a game.
The Saw franchise has more deadly games in store. Following the huge success of Saw X, Lionsgate has announced the 11th film in the franchise. Yes, Saw XI. Fans can circle September 27th, 2024 on their calendars, preferably in blood red. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Well, beloved actor Andre Bauer has died at age 61. He passed away after a brief illness, according to a representative, but details about the illness were not mentioned. Bauer, best known for his role as police officers on two very different shows, earning an Emmy for his time as police detective Frank Pemberton in the 1990 series Homicide: Life on the Street, and then in 2013 as a deadpan police captain in the comedy Brooklyn Nine-Nine. He was nominated for Emmy Awards 11 times, won twice in his decades-long career.
All right, we are in the middle of the holiday season. With it comes many fun activities that we all love to enjoy. Of course, maybe one of your favorites, enjoying all of the holiday lights and the decorations all over Delmarva. Take a look at your screen now. We have a beautiful home here in Ocean View. Those lights are just perfect. Chef's kiss. I love how you did those. Also, the Santa on the door getting a very well-deserved spotlight. He's very busy this time of year.
Yeah, that I love it. That is just what you look for when you're looking for these holiday scenes outside these displays. And we would love to see how you decorate your house for the holiday season. So take a look at your screen. You can send your pictures and videos to coasttvnews.com/holidayhouse. Also, the Bless Our Children campaign in full swing. Already, we have collected over $200,000 to help provide Christmas for children who otherwise might go without.
Yeah, that is incredible. But of course, we all know this year creates many hardships for people in our community, and the need for help is even larger.
Thank you so much to everyone who has donated to the Bless Our Children campaign so far. As you can see, we are really starting to get so many cards and so many donations, and every single one of those is helping make sure children have a really fantastic Christmas on Delmarva. This card is so cute. It says, "Holly Jolly Christmas to you and a Happy New Year." This is from Edna Snowden from Georgetown. Edna, thank you so much. We are going to add your card to our tree. And if you want to donate, please learn how to do that on blessourchildren.org.
So if you'd like to make a donation, you can send a donation in a holiday card. We may read your well wishes on air. You can send a check or money order to the address on your screen, or you can donate online.
Yeah, thank you so much to everyone who has already donated and helping ensure every child on Delmarva has a very Merry Christmas.
Delmarva's Holiday House is brought to you by Bay to Beach Builders.
Today at 4 on Coast Life, join us for expert holiday tips with Seaside Krav Maga. Then we're heading to Vernon Powell to explore a treasure trove of gift ideas. Tune in for inspiration and excitement only on Coast Life Today at 4 on Coast TV.
Not everyone wants a big funeral. For those seeking a simple alternative, the Eastern Shore's most trusted family and funeral service offers another option. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Service is simple and affordable. A direct cremation tribute starts at just $15.95, or choose to have a small visitation service, serving Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia with easy consultation by phone and streamlined electronic documentation. Learn more at easternshorecremation.com. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Services, simply respectful.
At H&H Furniture and Appliances in Pocomoke, spruce up your home for the holidays and make this Christmas one to remember. Ask about our prompt delivery and 24-month interest-free financing on our huge in-stock selection. Kids love our children's selection, and so will you. Try out our full range of Serta mattresses, America's number one mattress brand. Browse appliances that you can depend on, like Speed Queen, and trust our professional and experienced installation and service team. Merry Christmas from H&H Furniture and Appliances in Pocomoke.
Take the DSN app with you wherever you go and never miss a game from your favorite local team. Whether you're on the road, stuck at the office, or out with friends and family, the DSN app notifies you when your team is on live so you can watch the game as it happens or watch videos on demand. Keep up with local sports all from one app. From your mobile device to Fire Stick, Roku, and Apple TV, download the DSN app today, driven by Preston Automotive Group.
The Property Brothers are back for a holiday dinner. Plus, we're 3 days away from the cast of The Color Purple.
Wednesday at 2 on Coast TV.
It is 5:46 on this Wednesday morning. And Bob, I told you, as we take a live look at Ocean City right now, I told you I wanted to tell you just a nice story, okay? So yesterday, I was leaving work. A woman came in, and she won an umbrella, a Paul Davis umbrella. And she said, I'm in here to pick it up early because Bob said, it's going to rain on Monday. She's like, I want to make sure I'm prepared. So she wasn't wrong, was she?
Yeah. You have to be prepared. You have to be prepared. And it looks like that's a good call on her part, because it looks like we are going to see that rain page later Sunday into Monday. And with that rain comes the wind and coastal impacts. More on that storm coming up. We've got several days of nice weather on the way, but chilly weather. And make sure you scan the QR code lower left part of your screen. That gets you to the Coast TV weather app. We've got that storm coming early next week, and you'll need that app. Here's our 5-day temperature trend. Cold the next 2 days, 48 today. A high of only 42 on Thursday. Then we add wind to the equation. It's going to feel much colder than that, probably in the 20s and 30s. 52 Friday, and then warming up into the mid-50s by this weekend. So the cold shot is short-lived. It's chilly this morning, frosty inland, 20s and low 30s. Del Mar, 29, 33 in Millsboro, 41 Indian River Inlet. So you're more than likely frost-free along the coast, but inland, leave extra time to scrape the frost. As we're looking at a light westerly breeze right now and mostly clear skies, yeah, it's cold out there right now, and even colder air is on the way. We've got a cold front through Pennsylvania into the Ohio Valley right now, and that will continue to sink to the southeast with Arctic high pressure behind it. So that's what's going to give us the cold weather for the next couple of days. So this morning, we do warm it into the low 40s by mid-morning. By noon, mid to maybe upper 40s around Longneck, Seaford around 46. We start to see the winds picking up from the northwest into the afternoon, and those temperatures start to slide tonight, and it gets cold, especially with the wind. Actual temperatures 20s and low 30s by morning, feeling much colder with the wind, and Thursday will be a chilly day, highs only in the upper 30s and low 40s. Those feels like temperatures upper 30s this afternoon, tonight 20s and low 30s around midnight, and then by tomorrow morning, look at this, feeling like low 20s inland areas with the wind. You're going to want to bundle up and feeling, well, pretty chilly right as we go into your Friday. Do you want to fast forward to that storm system on Monday? It looks like a coastal low is coming up the coast. The impacts will be wind,
maybe beach erosion, and also some heavy rain. Note the lack of any snow. No cold air around, just rain. And some of that will be heavy rain into Monday, maybe 1 to 3 inches. We'll be watching that system very closely. Paul Davis, 7-day forecast, 48 today, 27 tomorrow morning, only 42 the high on Thursday, but then 52 Friday. And for the weekend, dry Saturday, 54. Rain builds in later Sunday, 56. And then Monday could be a first alert weather day. We'll watch it for rain. And it could be heavy and then drying out and cooler on Tuesday.
All right, thanks, Bob. And just a little reminder for you all, if you have your phones near you, you can just scan the QR code on your screen right now. That'll take you to the First Alert weather app. It's very easy and it's free to download. It keeps you updated with all of the weather updates that you need throughout the day.
Ocean City gearing up to welcome the new year with a bang. The town says it will host fireworks on New Year's Eve, with the main event happening downtown on the beach at midnight near Dorchester Street. Other festivities start at 9 p.m. Ocean City says that the event is free and there will be parking at the inlet lot.
HGTV has named the 50 favorite small towns to visit for Christmas, and on the map for the first date is the first town. According to the report, the Lewis Christmas Parade, Historic Holiday House Tour, and Holiday Village Market showcase the city's festive spirit in a Hallmark-like setting.
Wreaths Across America Day is Saturday, and an event is set up for ceremonies all around the country. On your screen, you can see a convoy carrying those wreaths. It passed through Southbury, Connecticut yesterday en route to Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. A network of volunteers will place wreaths on millions of graves and military cemeteries. Here locally, that's Epworth Cemetery in Rehoboth Beach and the Delaware Veterans Memorial Cemetery in Millsboro.
Coming up on Coast TV News today, a young pregnant mother's worst nightmare, alone and suffering a stroke. How this expectant mother survived a serious medical event.
The chilly December temperatures continue the next couple of days with a warm up into the weekend, and then a significant storm is possible next week. I'll have your 10-day forecast leading up to Christmas coming up.
The doctors of Delmarva Chiropractic take great pride in offering the finest, most individualized care to their patients and stay on the cutting edge of healthcare and clinical interventions. As winners of Coastal Style and Metropolitan Magazine's Best Chiropractors for 7 years in a row, Doctors Lane, Brown, and Taylor help with conditions such as back pain, sciatica, headaches, concussions, dizziness, and much more. The clinic also offers laser therapy, decompression, acupuncture, and custom orthotics. Call Delmarva Chiropractic today and take the first step toward achieving your maximum potential.
Are leaves and debris causing issues with your gutter? No need to risk climbing a shaky ladder ever again. We have the permanent solution, Gutter Helmet, America's number one choice in gutter protection for over 40 years. Engineered to manage the heaviest of rainfalls, letting water flow freely. And the best part, never clean your gutters again, guaranteed. The lifetime warranty is transferable, so you can rest assured that you'll never have to replace your Gutter Helmet system. And right now, save 20% on your new gutters and Gutter Helmet. Call Gutter Helmet today for your free estimate.
Draper Holdings, parent company of WBOC and Coach TV, has an opening for a human resource specialist. Provide HR support for approximately 150 employees in 4 locations. Candidates should have an associate's degree with a background in recruitment, employee relations, and payroll. ADP and SHRM certification and a bachelor's degree are a plus. Join Draper Holdings as our newest human resource specialist with full benefits. Go to drapermediajobs.com to learn more and apply. Draper Holdings is an equal opportunity employer.
The Powerball jackpot is always a lot of money. Right now, it's a lot of money. Powerball is over $500 million.
That's a lot of money.
Please play responsibly.
Get ready to soar with the Hawks. Delmarva Sports Network is your exclusive home for UMES Hawks basketball. From the first whistle to the final buzzer, TSN will take you courtside. Experience the excitement of both the men's and women's teams with every dribble, steal, and three-pointer. To see the schedule or watch the games, go to DelmarvaSportsNetwork.com or download the DSN app. Join us all season long only on the Delmarva Sports Network, your exclusive home for UMES Hawks basketball.
The beach.
A pro- pregnancy, it's a time of joy and anticipation, but for some, it holds a hidden risk, the increased danger of stroke. Although relatively low compared to other health issues, the CDC reports that the risk is increasing in pregnant women.
In fact, pregnant women may be up to 3 times more likely to suffer a stroke than non-pregnant women at the same age. Marty Salt shows us one woman's story of survival.
Hi, Pumpkin. Brianna Grant was 24 years old and 24 weeks pregnant when...
I couldn't see anything. I mean, I couldn't even see my hand in front of my face.
Alone and slipping in and out of consciousness. When she woke up, she phoned a friend who called for help.
She was having symptoms because of a blockage of a major vessel in the head. She wasn't getting enough blood flow to the brain. When that happens to people, a small portion of the brain dies pretty much immediately, within a matter of minutes.
Although rare, Dr. Bellin says some problems associated with pregnancy can increase the risk of stroke. They include high blood pressure, preeclampsia, gestational diabetes, blood clots, and once a stroke happens, every minute counts.
We try to get the blood vessel open as quickly as possible.
He used a catheter through a small puncture in Brianna's hip.
We navigate that up into the neck, and then we put an even smaller tube up into the brain and essentially apply suction to that to suck the clot out.
This is before, where the artery is blocked right here, and this is after, where it's open and it all fills out.
When Brianna woke up, her speech was slurred and her entire left side was weak.
More worried at that point about him than I was myself.
The stroke didn't affect her unborn baby. And 3 months later...
So his name's Barrett. Yep, with one eye open. He was the reason why I've been working so hard to get better and to get my motion and my arm back.
The inspiration behind his mother's miraculous recovery. I'm Marty Salt reporting.
And her doctors still don't know what caused Brianna's stroke, but they emphasize the importance of keeping yourself and your baby healthy during pregnancy by not smoking, maintaining a healthy weight, choosing healthy foods, and staying physically active.
All right, it is 5:55 now. Time to check in with our coastal pet of the day, brought to you by Maggie's Pet Boutique.
Got pets here, Paige. You got pets. They're on your screen right now are Canine Support Labs, Autumn, the yellow lab, and Blue, the black lab. They love going to Fenwick Beach and the Assawoman Bay, and they were sent to us by Christopher, who says Autumn and Blue, they're always there to lend a helping paw.
I was getting a little confused because there's the yellow lab and then the black lab's name is Blue.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay. Just wanted
to... It looks like they're having fun. I love the Santa picture there.
Look at them. They're best buddies. We want to keep seeing your photos of your pets on Delmarva. Please keep sending us photos and telling us what makes your pet so special.
Now take a look at your screen. The email information is right there, and then you can watch weekdays from 5 to 7 a.m. to see all of the pets we feature.
All right, it is 5:56 now. Time for a quick look at your forecast before you head out your door.
Yeah, getting close to 50 degrees in some spots today, Bob, but probably we're not going to get over that hump on hump day.
It's going to be tough to get to 50 today, and especially tomorrow. We're going to be looking at falling temperatures with much colder air moving in. Here's your day part forecast. Leave extra time to scrape the windshield this morning, warm up the car, bundle up the kids, and temperatures slowly warming through the 40s, upper 40s, and the winds start to pick up from the north and west, and that will plunge those temperatures overnight. Paul Davis 10-day forecast down to 27 tomorrow morning, but feeling much colder with the wind, especially into Thursday, 42, 52 Friday, dry Saturday, rain builds in later Sunday, and maybe heavy rain and strong winds by Monday.
All right, thanks, Bob. Coming up in our 6 o'clock hour, Rehoboth Avenue roadblock, the reason for another delay and what was supposed to be Rehoboth Beach's big off-season project. That and more as Coast TV News Today continues.